Now that we've talked about some general keyboard shortcuts, let's talk about some browser-specific keyboard shortcuts. One of the nice new features in nearly all web browsers is the ability to have multiple web pages open in your browser via tabs. And you can see up here is a tab, and if I click the button next to it, I can open up a new tab, and it even says new tab. And I can go to a web page, and now I can switch between these two tabs, which can be very handy. Now I will go to a third tab, and now I can switch between all three of these. And you can see here I can scroll down and click on a link and do all this browsing in one tab while the other two remain unchanged. Now if I see a link in a tab and I want to open up that link in a new tab, I can press the middle mouse button on the link, and the middle mouse button is your scroll wheel. If you can push that scroll wheel in, then that acts as your middle mouse button. And you can see this link was opened up in its own tab. This is great when you have a really useful web page full of information and you can see it has lots of links that you want to follow, but you don't want to have to always go back, hit the back button to return to this page. So you can use your middle mouse button to open up a link in a new page, and that way, you know, if you find other links in here, you can progress through those links, and you can always go back to the original page and click on a new link. There I used the middle mouse button, and it opened up this page in a new tab. Sometimes the text or images on a web page are very small and hard to see. You can make text and images larger by holding down the control key and pressing the plus key. And you can see I'm pressing the plus key here, and it's making the text larger. And if I scroll down, you can see it even makes the images larger. Pressing the control and minus key will make everything smaller. If you press and hold control and zero, that will bring everything back to the default size. Now there are a couple of ways to scroll down a page. I can move my mouse cursor over to this sidebar and click and drag to scroll down, or I can click the little down arrow at the bottom. But another handy keyboard shortcut is if I don't want to move the mouse over there, all I need to do is press the space bar. And pressing the space bar will automatically move the page down one browser area width. You can go back up by holding down the shift key and pressing the space bar. Now let's say you've clicked through a number of links in a tab and you want to go back. Well, you can hit the back button, which is up here. It's normally an arrow. Or you can press the backspace key. You see, when I press the backspace key, that automatically moves me back in the browsing history. Now, if you have a lot of tabs open, you can physically select them by moving your mouse cursor over them and clicking on the tab, or you can hold down the control key and pressing the tab button. You see, I can control tab through each of these tabs. You can move backwards by holding control and shift and tapping the tab button. You see, now I'm going backwards. So to summarize, control and plus makes the text and images larger. Control and minus makes the text and images smaller. Control and zero brings everything back to the default size. Backspace moves you backwards in the browser history. The space bar scrolls down for you, and the control and tab keys cycle through all of the open tabs.